Good morning, students. Today we are going to see a different part of the lesson from our topic photosynthesis. From this topic, we are going to see today internal structure of the leaf. Actually, leaf is very important. Already for the photosynthesis, leaf is important. Why? Because leaf only have chlorophyll. With that chlorophyll, leaf can conduct photosynthesis. Already previously we discussed about photosynthesis and how that photosynthesis is conducted, what are the factors required for the photosynthesis, everything we discussed. Today in this topic we are going to see the infrastructure of the leaf. So leaf is suited for the conduction of photosynthesis. How it is suited? Let us see. Here a TS of leaf diagram already drawn here. TS of means transverse section of leaf. Transverse means we cut the leaf like this. Transverse. And we observe that leaf inside the microscope. And through that microscope this diagram is given here. And see this the diagram where some parts are there. This is a cuticle, outermost layer of the leaf is called cuticle. After that, upper epidermis. After that, palisade parenchyma. See this, this is called palisade parenchyma. And round structures are called, spongy parenchyma. This is parenchyma. And here, lower epidermis. On the lower epidermis, again, you can see stromata here. They are the, already we know about stromata. Stromata are present on the lower side of the leaf. Every time, lower side of the leaf, you can see the stromata. And these are important for gas exchange. The carbon dioxide, from the atmosphere will enter into the leaf through this stomata only. And after conduction of photosynthesis, the plant can produce oxygen that also will come out through this stomata only. So these are called leaf openings. Okay, actually gas exchange. What is meant by gas exchange? Entering of carbon dioxide into the leaf and coming out of oxygen from the leaf. This is called gas exchange that can be conducted through this stomata. That's why where stomata there, there we can see some air spaces. This is called airspace. Through this airspace, that means air entered, carbon dioxide entered this airspace through stomata and wait here, slowly diffuses into tissue. And here see, this is spongy parenchyma. The spongy parenchyma has some dots we have to keep. These are dots, not dots. Actually, in our compound microscope, we can see like dots. But if you observe in electron microscope, these dots equal to they are chloroplasts. This is a chloroplast. Chloroplasts present in the palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. These chloroplasts are more number of chloroplasts are present in palisade parenchyma, less number of chloroplasts are in a spongy parenchyma. That means rate of photosynthesis will be more in a palisade parenchyma, rate of photosynthesis less in a spongy parenchyma. Actually, for example, take a leaf. In the leaf section, what you can see? Mesophyll tissue. Mesophyll tissue means the palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma commonly called as mesophyll tissue. In the mesophyll tissue, what we can see? Dots we can see. These dots equal to chloroplasts. Actually, you know, through our compound microscope, what is there in our schools generally, through that microscope, you can see only the structure. But chloroplasts, if you want to see clearly, we should use only electron microscope. So the chloroplast. Inside the chloroplast, thylakoids will be there. In previous class, we discussed about thylakoids. In the thylakoids, chlorophyll will be there. So these are the shapes. They are all important. So here, the structure, everything you can see. So rate of photosynthesis will be in a palisade parenchyma and rate of photosynthesis will be less in a spongy parenchyma. This is the entire structure of leaf. And mostly, through this stomata, the carbon dioxide enters into the leaf. Carbon dioxide will enter into the leaf. And the oxygen will come out from the leaf. Oxygen is the byproduct of this photosynthesis, oxygen is byproduct of photosynthesis, will come out this stomata only. Now, this stomata not only for gas exchange, it has important transpiration. Already we know about transpiration, previously we discussed it. What is meant by transpiration? Excess water, what is there in the plant, can send out in the form of water vapor through stomata. For that, also it is important. So, stomata play an important role in the gas exchange as well as is important for the transpiration also, transpiration process also. In that way, the plant can conduct photosynthesis with the help of structure. This is the infrastructure of leaf. And the remaining points, how photosynthesis will be conducted, what are the stages of then photosynthesis, we will discuss next lesson. That is about light reaction. Photosynthesis contains two important stages. One is light reaction, second one is dark reaction. But dark reaction, light reaction, we can't discuss in our level of 7th class. We can discuss in higher classes. The light reaction, light is important for the light reaction. Already we discussed previously, the factors required for the photosynthesis are sunlight, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide, water. These are four factors important. But in this lesson, we discussed how the leaf is suited for the condition of potency. We discussed that way. So remaining points, what are they related to photosynthesis? We'll discuss tomorrow next lesson. Okay, good. Okay, bye, bye, Nana.